feel that they are describing something that's absolutely based on fact. And when you look at it, Jack, look at our society. At every level, it is levels and different groups parasiting off other people and other groups all the way down. Look, I mean, what greater expression of the parasitical mind could you have than the human banking system? It mirrors the parasitical nature of these archon entities. Everything. I mean, what is it doing? And in fact, what banking is doing, because everything is energy, it is trawling and vampiring our energy. What is money? It's energy. You put it in your pocket, you put it in your bank account, that energy becomes attached to you while it's in your ownership and therefore in your energy field. It picks up your energy. It then moves on to someone else. It picks up their energy. And when it eventually comes back to source, those who've put the money out there, all these networks around the Rothschilds, then they are trawling not only energy back plus interest. What is the interest, Jack? You know, in the holographic world, it's more money on top of principal. But the interest at the energetic level is human energy on top of the energy of money that was put out there in the first place. They know that what I've just said about money is true. There was a document, I'm sure you've heard of it, no doubt, that came to light years ago called Quiet Weapons for Quiet Wars. And it described in some detail how mass social engineering and mass mind control goes on. And one of the things it talked about at some length was how money is used in this end. And this is what it said about money in the context of what we've just talked about. Economics is only a social extension of a natural energy system. Since energy is the key to all activity on the face of the earth, it follows that in order to attain a monopoly of energy, raw materials, goods and services, everything you've just mentioned, and to establish a world system of slave labor, it is necessary to have a first strike capability in the field of economics. In order to maintain our position, it is necessary that we have absolute first knowledge of the science of control over all economic factors and the first experience at engineering the world economy. In order to achieve such sovereignty, you must at least achieve this one end, that the public will not make either the logical or mathematical connection between economics and the other energy sciences, or learn to imply such knowledge. To make a short story of it all, it was discovered that an economy obeyed the same laws as electricity, and that all of the mathematical theory and practical and computer knowledge developed for the electronic field could be directly applied to the study of economics. This discovery was not openly declared, you surprise me, and its more subtle implications were and are kept a closely guarded secret. For example, that in an economic model, wait for this, my goodness me, for example, that in an economic model, human life is measured in dollars, and that the electric spark generated when opening a switch connected to an active inductor is mathematically analogous to the initiation of war. It's all happening, Jack, in the electromagnetic field.
In the next few minutes, I'm going to share with you a simple but powerful method that's going to help you make boatloads of cash without hard work, live every day of your life in blissful happiness, and enjoy true unlimited freedom. Attract the partner of your dreams and enjoy unbelievable red-hot romance every day. And all it will take you is less than 10 minutes a day to make this all happen.
In life for free, but you can give them to the birds and bees. I want money. That's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I want. love gives me such a thrill. But your love won't pay my bills. I want money. Get everything, it's true. What it don't get, I can't use. I want money.
And I'm not going to charge you the tens of thousands of dollars it could cost to learn this material at the seminars. I'm not going to charge you the $3,997 that most personal development gurus charge. I'm not even going to charge you $1,000, or $600, or $497 either, or $297, or $147. Because today, if you've gotten here before the sold-out sign, hit the big orange Add to Cart button below right now.
People, to a large extent, even those that have opened their mind to some of it, is still a game, it's still an add-on. It's still train spotting or plane spotting. It's still a hobby. But if they really knew the scale, the nature of the world that is designed to be introduced, then if their hair isn't curled, it would curl, and if it is curled, it would uncurl, because they'd go running home crying to their mum if they knew what was really planned. And this is why people like me and you and others have given our lives to try to alert people. To, you know, like I said earlier, if you think it's bad now, if you don't like what's happening now, well, strap in, mate, because multiply it by 1,000% and then multiply it some more by the time we get to 2030, 2050. You know, people have no idea. And you know, it's this is a big thing, you know. One of the greatest ways that this cabal prosper and control is simply the sense of me. Does it affect me? What's in it for me? What are the consequences for me? Well, the consequences for me, if I go with it, is I'll be a big star and I make lots of money and people cheer me and I'll be great. And what's the consequences for me of challenging this stuff? Oh, well, it's not so good. It's not so good. So I'm not going to challenge it, because what's the best thing for me? Going with it. So we have these people in dark suits administering this thing. We have the bureaucrats. We have the people in uniform. We have all of these people. We have these, I tell you, Jack, we have these celebrities, some of which have actually contacted me, and I've met one or two, and they've gone, oh, you're doing a great job. You know, thank you very much. So now, what are you going to do with the massive platform, public platform that you have, to communicate this information and make a difference? Answer, silence.
Yeah, I know. I've had the same
because
thing happen.
Yeah. He's in it for me. Oh, I'm glad you're doing it, Dave. I'm glad you're doing it, Jack. But me, if I did it, well, I'd lose this, I'd lose that, and I wouldn't get a big movie anymore. I would lose me contract and all that stuff. All this business, it's me. Well, that's fine. But one day, I say to these people, me is going to knock on your door, and you're going to realize that reality dawns, and you're going to realize the world that by your silence, when you had the opportunity, you have allowed to unfold for the later years of your life and for most of the life of your kids and all the life of your grandkids.
David, I was fairly rich and famous. I was running big companies and making a lot of money and doing what I was supposed to do for the most part and playing my part, and it was very nice. I got a lot of perks, and this is what people say. Well, Jack, you're just doing this to make money and to be famous. No, I actually already was. I actually gave that up to do this. And it's very similar with you, even on a higher level, head of the Green Party, BBC presenter, sports athlete star in England, all of that. You could have kept going on your path. You'd be living in a giant mansion on the hill right now, reading and repeating the news for people, but instead, you did this.
I wouldn't, Jack. I'd have taken the pill by now if that had been my life. I'd have taken the pill and left this reality, I tell you. The thought of continuing in that life, in that world, oh my goodness me, I just shudder. But, I have no problem with people, pursuing their career. I have no problem with people making money and all that, as long as it's legitimate and not screwing people. The problem I have is people who have a platform to make a difference, who say they understand what's going on and they're so glad you're doing what you're doing, who then do nothing to use that platform because they fear the consequences for them. It's all about me, me, me. And, that me, me, me is one of the... It's often lost, when people list divide and rule structures and techniques. They say religion, they say race, they say income bracket and all that stuff and what have you. You very rarely hear on the list me, me, me. That is the greatest divide and ruler of all in so many ways, because I'm going to make my decisions on not on what is right, not on what is just, not on what needs to be done to turn this world around. I'm going to make my decisions on what's right for me, what benefits me, what makes good consequences for me. And if we go on doing that for much longer, we will me, me, me us into them, 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 because we will give the very divide and rule necessary. It's like that great line by the pastor in Nazi Germany. First they came for the Jews, I was not a Jew, so I did nothing. Then they came for the communists, I was not a communist, so I did nothing. Then they came for the trade unionists, I was not a trade unionist, so I did nothing. Then they came for me, and there was no one else left to speak out for me. And this is what's happening. And if we keep looking the other way, then eventually, like I say, me, me, me knocks on our door and asks for our papers. And by then, all the other people who together could have changed it, they're all no longer here. And this is why we cannot go on the way we are. Because, I think it was Einstein who said, doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results, is the ultimate confirmation of insanity. So therefore, we have to do something differently if we're going to change what we're constantly repeating. And to do that, we need to look in the mirror and say, what do I have to change about me? And the big thing we all have to do is say, what do we have to do to contribute or to stop underpinning this system of human control that's getting more incessant and more extreme by the day? That's the first thing. There's nothing more important in anyone's life than that. Oh, my kids are more important. Okay, so what kind of world are your kids going to live in if you don't make a contribution to this, if you don't stop underpinning it? Everything comes from this. Oh, no, my health's more important. They want to destroy your health, and you've seen nothing yet if nothing's done. My bank account's more important. Oh, really? Well, what about when they crash the banking system and whatever you've got in the bank is worthless? Which it is now, except we take it seriously. Everything, people, comes down to sorting this out. It is the number one priority on planet Earth.